Jonathan Schick back with you with another episode of Schtisselman. So here we have back with episode 5 again, and we're here to discuss the what's going on with Shulem visiting the sons of and the widow of Rabbi Chesson, the rabbi from the cheder, from the school who died. And you saw earlier in the scene how Shulem, so to speak, was happy about it, which certainly was not the right response. But now he tries to play as a good Jew, if you will, and pays a visit to what we call the Shiva house, S-H-I-V-A. Shiva is the Hebrew letters and Hebrew word for 7. The custom is to mourn for 7 days following the death of a loved one. That could be, again, a father, a mother, a brother, a sister, a spouse, or, God forbid, a child. All these are God forbid, but anyway, so what are they doing in this Shiva house? First of all, you'll notice a few nuances. When Shulem walks in, he doesn't speak first. He waits and hears a question from the sons. They asked him about, so tell us something about our father. That's actually a Jewish custom, which is that you don't speak first when you enter the house of mourning, because it's about those who are mourning and their loved one and not about you. It's not about you to find out. Like sometimes someone would walk in, be brash or be just inappropriate by saying, well, how did he die? Or how old was he? Time of death? Like what was the time of death? I mean, just ridiculous questions that could be asked that are embarrassing and are hurtful and are actually a sin rather than a mitzvah, a good deed done at the house of mourning. But visiting the house of mourning is a very big mitzvah, a very big good deed. And we'll talk a little bit about more of the some of the things that the customs there, including you notice they were sitting on low chairs. They were not wearing shoes. They were in their, so to speak, stocking feet or socks. And they also had their shirts ripped. All these things, and also the mirrors were covered. All these things, it's beyond the scope of this video to get into every specific one, but the general reason is to have a physical outward showing of mourning. Sometimes the physical influences the internal. After you lose a loved one, sometimes it takes time. And one of the reasons we give 7 days is to allow that time to be that you don't work, you don't go to work, you really stop what you're doing. And you sit at the home and visitors come to comfort you in your mourning. And also, so sometimes it takes time to start the grieving process. Sometimes the physical things can influence the internal, the external can influence the internal, and you can have the ability to recognize the loss through these outward sort of signs, if you will. But in this scene, Shulem behaved and waited to be asked a question before he responded, then went over to the women's side and gave his, the words that you say as you leave the house of mourning, which is that Hamakom Yinachem Etchem Toch Shar Evlei Tzion BeYushalayim, that God should comfort you among the mourners of Zion in Jerusalem, meaning the rest of the Jewish people, etc. And those are the words that you leave. So Shulem behaved here, but later on in the episode, as you'll see at the end, he didn't behave so well because the reality is that His activities with Eliza and with these other widows, bordering certainly on flirtation and whatnot, is actually uncommon, to say the least, among the Hasidic community. Of course, there are outliers, but for a widow to sort of come on to these women through food, okay, and through these, and yes, they'll leave the door open, as we learned in a previous video, but is rather uncharacteristic. Normally what would happen if he was looking for to remarry would be a date set up a little bit like the hotel lobby or something a little bit less formal, but certainly not something where they would generally start hitting on them as they serve them their soup. Anyway, with that, we will continue on to season 1, episode 6 next time. Hope you enjoy and don't forget to subscribe. Have a Shabbat Shalom as well.